Are you serious? Are you serious? The floodwaters are raging here in Indiana. The worst floods in 45 years have hit the Midwest, especially in Indiana. Crews are using boats and helping residents to evacuate from their homes in northern Indiana after rainstorms have been sweeping across the Midwest yesterday and today. Matter of fact, here in West Lafayette, Indiana, the rains have not stopped for about 4 days. I'm sure that the Wabash River is cresting, but it will even get worse as the water comes down from the more north of us. Already, Elkhart, Indiana, flooding unbelievable. 19 people evacuated this morning as crews using boats are rescuing people out of the melting snow and the flood rivers as the waters are flowing in the low-lying areas, not only in Indiana, but in several states. The storm system started pushing heavy rain, snow, and ice into the region, and the weather has already been blamed for hundreds of car crashes, several fatalities, including deaths of four people along a slippery interstate in Nebraska. 19 people have been evacuated from their homes in Elkhart, Indiana, a town just east of South Bend, Indiana, and local schools are closed because of the flooding, and the emergency shelters were set up to evacuate evacuees overnight. Now, the city has not seen flooding like this in 45 years, according to the mayor. We also have recorded snowfall in addition to consistent rain. So homes, because now it's gotten cold, now it's going to freeze. Homes and streets also were flooded in the South Bend area, and forecasters are predicting that the swollen St. Joe River is not going to crest till later today. The National Weather Service has issued flood warnings for parts of several states. Texas, Illinois, Ohio, Arkansas, where strong winds have toppled over power lines and damaged buildings. Winter weather advisories have also been issued, including for Oklahoma and for Kansas. And in Michigan, flooded streets have stranded motorists, school buses in Flint, Michigan. Flint, Michigan can't get a break, no matter what they do. They got poisoned water. They got somebody, there's dead bodies found in the park, dismembered. There's dead bodies floating in the in the water treatment plant. They just can't get a break. Now they have flooded streets, and also in Flint, Michigan, it's washed. There's a washout from heavy rains may have caused two freight trains to derail near Grand Rapids, Michigan. Nobody was hurt. Residents also are saying that in Mattawan, they're using sandbags in Michigan there to protect their homes and businesses as the river has rose above its banks. And just everywhere you turn, there's a chaotic weather. Now, there was also in Bourbonnais, Illinois, Kankakee, Illinois, a 52-year-old woman was found dead as her car submerged in the river south of Chicago. This woman apparently lost control of her car and she fell into a rain-filled ditch where she drowned. And it's just getting uglier, folks. There's been in Minnesota, state officials said winter weather has caused 400 car crashes and 250 cars have spun out, flying off of the road, and has left two people dead in Minnesota. And the storm system has also stretched all the way to Texas, where severe weather officials said three tornadoes hit. One struck early Tuesday in a rural area near Joshua, Texas, destroying at least two mobile homes, severely damaging several others. And a mother and her disabled daughter were injured when one of the twisters demolished their mobile home. So all of this is going on as extreme weather conditions continue to break out across the United States. We'll keep you up to speed on everything going on as it's an apocalyptic situation. Let's pray it doesn't get any worse. But we're moving into March now, guys. We're moving into March. We start to really move into heavy tornado season. And with the extreme weather conditions and the shifting in that bipolar vortex, they call it a polar vortex. I call it a bipolar vortex because actually the vortex separates into two vortex streams, and they are creating totally extreme different weather conditions. So we're really witnessing some. And is this all part of the effects of Planet X? Is when David Mead said, look out, in the spring it's going to begin, extreme weather conditions, volcanic eruptions, which we're definitely seeing those in Mount Cinnabung, just exploded beyond our dreams, and other volcanoes. And we have the super volcano Yellowstone now really rumbling in the last 3 days. And just there's a lot going on. So we'll keep a close eye on all of this. And remember, David Mead says that Planet X will affect us in the spring, but should be visible in October of 2018. Well, we'll wait and see. We've heard this those predictions before, and I'm not finding fault with anyone. Hope no one. This is still no one really knows. Are you saved? Let's just wait and see what happens. Maybe David Mead's right. The effects of Planet X are happening. Nibiru are happening now. Give your life to Jesus Christ. He's coming soon.